conversations, accidents and accusations, messages and misperceptions paralyze my mind. Buses, cars and airplanes leaving, burning fumes of gasoline, and everyone is running, and I come to find a refuge in the easy silence that you make for me.
I think tolerance means that someone's really tall.
I think no mean if someone's tall. And I think that's about it.
You keep the world at bay.
Okay, die for sin. I have no idea.
I really don't know.
My friend got hurt and she said, I can't wait until Christmas, can't you? And I said, I'm Jewish. And then she just started to laugh.
They bullied me for how I was playing and who my friends were. That made me feel really sad.
Only make more questions. I need something to believe in.
When I first came to Aquilines, I really hated it. I thought people were really afraid of me and whatnot, just because I was different. In the first week of school, I ate lunch by myself in the back of the gym. I've had an incident with racism at this school. It started out as just like a joke between me and her. We were just like playing the dozen, like talking about each other back and forth over text. And then it escalated. She ended up saying that my people came here under boats and my family is all slaves and we should be hanging from trees. And that kind of pissed me off a lot. But eventually she came up and apologized.
In sixth grade, I was not in school, and the next day my friend told me that there was a kid who were saying names to me. And then my teacher called me and he told me that this kid was telling everyone, where is the small person? And then all of them were like, what? And then he said, where's the midget? And then they were all angry. Then I heard about it. And I thought, that's not the right way to say it. I have a name, which is Isabel. I think this needs to make a change. I might be small, but I'm smart and everyone is the same, but in a different way.
I was diagnosed with Tourette's in fourth grade. And it started to get worse as I reached high school. I originally went to school in the city for the past 3 years, so I took BART every day. It was a pretty long ride, and so I'd sit next to people, and maybe a couple stops in, they'd change seats. And I don't know what it was just a little thing, but it really got to me. And I mean, there are some cases where just a woman like offered me a mask because she thought I was sick or something, and started to realize just how uneducated on Tourette's. And
I grew up in a really poor household. My mom was a single mother and she went to school while we were kids. So we basically lived off of student loans and food stamps and welfare. People would joke a lot about having a crummy car or make jokes about buying generic brands. Kids making jokes about being poor made it so that I wasn't comfortable at school a lot of times.
Racism.
Discrimination.
Sexist.
Sexist.
Hate crime.
Well, hate crime.
A racial animus.
The 15-year-old was relentlessly bullied before she took her own life in January.
A New York City taxi driver was stabbed multiple times Tuesday after a drunken passenger determined he was Muslim.
The parents of Asher Brown, who you can see above, complained that their son was being bullied and harassed in school. The bullies called him faggot and queer. They shoved him, they punched him. And in spite of his parents' calls to counselors and principals, the harassment, intimidation, and threats continued. For years, it continued. A couple of weeks ago, after being bullied at school, Asher went home, found his father's gun, and shot himself in the head. His father found Asher dead when he came home from work. Asher was 13 years old.
Thank you.
doesn't matter what your skin color and in your eyesight or your religion, it doesn't matter. You can still be friends with somebody.
Respect means that to like be nice to someone, and then if you be nice to them, then they'll be nice back to you.
It means you're being really nice to someone.
Pain throws your heart to their skin color, their hair color. It doesn't really matter. You can still be friends with them.
No, it won't all come.
My friend Peter has been bullied.
He asked me if I could protect him, and I said yes. I stood it up for them because they were my friends, and I didn't want them to get bullied anymore. And it was just really taking away the time that I had with my friends.
You know it's nothing new.
I had a brother with a neurological disorder, so he couldn't talk or walk, so he was in a wheelchair. And when he was 5 years old, decided to send him to school at Spring Hill. And he was mostly kindergarten. He was in the class most of the time with the other kids. And my parents were worried that they wouldn't like accept or like know what to think of him or anything. But this one girl, she was like an angel, and they'd have like little parties at our house, and she knew how to make him smile, which was chill. She'd like blow on his face and he'd smile, and in every picture she'd be like, and he'd be smiling. So
the first day of freshman year, I was a new kid, I was a new student, and I only had one friend here at Algolani's. And that one friend introduced me to all my friends today, and it was really cool because I didn't have to go like the first month at school here just by myself eating lunch. I actually like got to know new people, and they become my friends today, and they were really supportive.
When I came out, it was with my discrimination case. My family did not know that I was a lesbian, and I was very desperate and afraid and didn't know how they would react. I told my mother, and then the very next day my father called me on the phone. Now keep in mind, my father never called me on the phone, ever, 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 ever. And so when he called and I picked up the phone and he said, "Hi, this is Dad," I thought for sure that he was gonna disown me. I mean, I really didn't know, I was very scared. And he said, "Well, your mom told me what you talked about with her yesterday, and I just want you to know that you're my daughter and I love you. Here's your mother." And he handed her the phone. And I have to say, it was so powerful because my father told me that he loved me once in my life. And that was the time. And he saved it for a brilliant time. It could not have been better timing.
I pledge because I want people to see past this and see this.
I pledge because I am not a gardener.
I don't own a laundromat.
I've never been a cab driver.
I pledge because there is no black or white or yellow. There's just us.
I pledge because this world is gonna be better for my daughter.
I pledge because everybody deserves wedding gifts.
I pledge because I don't believe in racism, sexism, or any ism.
I pledge because it's time.